Namaskar, hello and a very warm welcome viewers. You're watching this special presentation of Sansad TV on parliamentary committees. Parliament is the supreme legislative body of India. The visible part of Parliament's work takes place on the floor of the House. In a year, Parliament meets for the budget session, the monsoon session and the winter session. This part of Parliament's work is televised and closely watched. However, Parliament has another important forum, its parliamentary committees, through which a considerable and substantial amount of its work gets done. Recently, the parliamentary standing committees were reconstituted. In the next 20 minutes, let me take you through all the important changes and all the important developments. Come along.
Parliament of India deliberates on complex matters that often need technical expertise for better understanding. Parliamentary committees provide members the forum to engage with domain experts and government officials in their study. These committees also help in building consensus across political parties. Committees have closed-door meetings that allow members to freely question and discuss the issues. There are 24 departmentally related parliamentary standing committees. Each of them oversee a set of ministries. These committees were first set up in 1993 to help Parliament keep pace with the growing complexity of governance. They also examine policy issues of respective ministries and make suggestions to the government.
Standing committees have an important role in a parliamentary system. The time of Parliament is limited. And very often there is not enough time to discuss and deliberate on technical issues before Parliament. And this is where parliamentary committees come in. Parliamentary committees are referred to as mini parliaments, and their role is to look at legislation, budgets, and other important policy issues which are being tackled by the various ministries of the Government of India. Parliamentary committees also play the role of a bridge. The bridge of bringing technical inputs to Parliament and also getting inputs from stakeholders who might get impacted by legislation being piloted by the government. So, in essence, parliamentary committees do a lot of heavy lifting when it comes to the technical functioning of Parliament. For example, the Parliamentary Committee on Labour examined the three labour code bills which were being piloted by the government. The committee invited representations from a range of stakeholders and also the government. The inputs from the stakeholders and the government then helped the committee form its recommendations. The government, when it was getting the bill passed in Parliament, accepted 75% of the committee's recommendations.
Constituted under Rule 268, each of the standing committees consists of not more than 31 members. 10 of these members are nominated by the chairman from the Rajya Sabha, while 21 members are nominated by the speaker from the Lok Sabha. 8 committees serviced by the Rajya Sabha and 16 serviced by the Lok Sabha are recast in September every year by both the presiding officers of Parliament in consultation with the respective party leaders and the government.
Each standing committee has to consider and report on the demands for grants of the related ministries and departments. The committees examine bills pertaining to related ministries or departments referred to it by the chairman of Rajya Sabha or speaker of the Lok Sabha. The panels also consider annual reports of the ministries and departments. Besides this, they also consider national basic long-term policy documents presented to the House, if referred to it by the chairman or the speaker. In the reconstitution of the panels, BJP member Sushil Kumar Modi was appointed the new chairman of the Parliamentary Committee on Personnel, Public Grievances, Law and Justice in place of Bhupendra Yadav, who has become a minister now. The Ministry of Personnel, Public Grievances and Pensions and Ministry of Law and Justice come under the purview of the committee's scrutiny. All other existing chairpersons were retained. Vijay Sai Reddy was reappointed as the chairman of the Committee on Commerce. Ram Gopal Yadav was reappointed as the chairman of Committee on Health and Family Welfare. Anand Sharma as the chairman of Committee on Home Affairs. Dr. Vinay P. Sahasrabuddhe, chairman of the Committee on Human Resource Development. Dr. K. Keshava Rao as chairman of the Committee on Industry. Jairam Ramesh as the chairman of Committee on Science and Technology, Environment, Forests and Climate Change. T.G. Venkatesh as chairman of the Committee on Transport, Tourism and Culture. P.C. Gadi Godur, chairman of the Committee on Agriculture. Kani Moy as the chairperson of the Committee on Chemicals and Fertilizers. Rakesh Singh, chairman of the Committee on Coal and Steel. Jualo Ram, chairman of the Committee on Defense. Rajiv Ranjan Singh, chairman of the Committee on Energy. P.P. Chaudhary, chairman of the Committee on External Affairs. Jayant Sinha as chairman of the Committee on Finance. Sudeep Bandopadhyay, chairman of the Committee on Food, Consumer Affairs and Public Distribution. Dr. Shashi Tharoor, chairman of the Committee on Information and Technology. Bhartahari Mehtab as chairman of the Committee on Labour. Ramesh Viduri as the chairman of the Committee on Petroleum and Natural Gas. Radhamohan Singh as the chairman of the Committee on Railways. Pratap Rao Jadhav as the chairman of the Committee on Rural Development. Rama Devi as the chairperson of the Committee on Social Justice and Empowerment. Jagdambika Pal as the chairman of the Committee on Urban Development. And Dr. Sanjay Jaiswal as chairman of the Committee on Water Resources.
Rajya Sabha Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu nominated 237 members to the 24 department-related parliamentary standing committees. 50 members have been changed to new committees. While most of these changes were suggested by their own parties, attendance and punctuality remained key denominators.
Chaya Verma has gone from the Committee on Agriculture to Social Justice and Empowerment. Professor Manoj Kumar Jha from Railways to Labour. Shakti Singh Gohil from IT to Transport. Sasmit Patra from Education to Personnel, Public Grievances and Law. Abhishek Manu Singhvi from Defence to Home. Derek O'Brien from Transport to Home. Indu Bala Goswami from Health to Science and Technology. Mohsen Noor from Commerce to Water Resources. MC Mary Com from Food to Urban Development.
Being nominated to the Parliamentary Standing Committee on Law and Justice is indeed a great opportunity and a wonderful privilege, because the areas that are identified under this committee are quite diverse, from the Ministry of Personnel, Public Grievances to Law and Justice. I think these are multifarious areas and I look forward to working very strongly on them, especially areas relating to the functioning of virtual courts, the functioning of alternative dispute resolution, relating to pensioners' grievances and its social impact, the review of the legal aid system under the NALSA Act, in terms of civil services reforms through Mission Karmayogi and the review of working of the Central Information Commission and the State Information Commissioners. So these and many such issues relating to pendency of cases, vacancy in the courts, are important areas that this committee is focused on. And I'm very confident that under the chairmanship of Shri Sushil Modi ji, this committee will perform extremely well, and I will work extremely hard to ensure that the outputs and the contributions that I provide help through this committee to the government to take necessary steps to improve the position of judiciary, the position of the judicial system, the functioning of the courts, and ensure that proper infrastructural development as well as filling up of vacancies in the courts are ensured.
मेरे पास इंफॉर्मेशन एंड टेक्नोलॉजी कमेटी में मैंने काम किया, एक बहुत बड़ा अच्छा टेन्योर रहा, अच्छे साथियों के साथ काम हुआ, शशि थरूर जी हमारे चेयरपर्सन रहे, और अभी पार्टी का डिसीशन था, हमारी पार्टी तय करती है कि कौन इस साल कौन सी कमेटी में रहेगा, तो एक नई कमेटी, स्टैंडिंग कमेटी ट्रांसपोर्ट टूरिज्म एंड कल्चर, TTC के नाम से जानी जाती है, उस कमेटी का मैं मेंबर बना हूँ। मुझे खुशी है कि वहाँ एक नया फील्ड में काम करने का अवसर मिलेगा। ट्रांसपोर्ट में काम कुछ हो रहा है, कुछ काम रुके पड़े हुए हैं, कुछ नए सजेशंस हैं, वक्त के साथ बदलाव ज़रूरी है, कल्चर में भी टूरिज्म में भी, तो इन सारी बातों पे हमारे सुझाव ज़रूर रखेंगे।
All the three Rajyasabha members of the Shiv Sena were also moved to the new committees.
Sanjay Raut has gone from the Committee on Defence to External Affairs. Anil Desai from Coal and Steel to Commerce. And Priyanka Chaturvedi from Commerce to Transport, Tourism and Culture. Data for the Rajya Sabha members suggest that 9 BJP members, 6 Trinamool, 4 from the Congress, 3 members each from Shiv Sena, CPM, RJD, YSRCP and 2 each from DMK, BJD and TRS have been shifted to new panels after consultations with the parties. All other parties have seen at least one member shift to the other panel. Newly elected Rajya Sabha MPs have also been nominated to the reconstituted committees. However, their composition changed as some members had been inducted into the Union Council of Ministers in the cabinet expansion on 7 July. Former Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad is now on the Parliamentary Committee on Finance headed by Jayant Sinha. Former Ministers Prakash Javadekar and Harsh Vardhan are in the External Affairs Committee headed by P.P. Chaudhary.
Before the reconstitution of the department-related parliamentary standing committees, Rajya Sabha Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu sent a detailed record of participation by the members in committee meetings over the past year to the political parties, calling them to nominate members only based on their participation and interests.
Rajya Sabha Secretariat collated details on the participation by 243 members of the upper house from 32 political parties, as well as independents and nominated members, in 361 meetings of these committees held in the period of September 2020 to August 2021. 115 members clocked the attendance of 50% or more. In all, 131 members, accounting for 54% of the house, reported attendance of 50% or more in these committees. The attendance of about one-third members of the house has been below 30%. In Rajya Sabha panel, 16 members had the distinction of having attended all the scheduled meetings in the last year. These include 10 members from the BJP, 3 from Congress, 1 each from Samajwadi Party, DMK and Telangana Rashtra Samiti. The members who attended all the scheduled meetings of the respective committees were Professor Ram Gopal Yadav of SP, P. Wilson of DMK, Dr. K. Keshava Rao of TRS, Anand Sharma of the Congress, Jairam Ramesh of the Congress and Chaya Verma of the Congress. From the BJP, Dr. Subramanian Swamy, Rakesh Sinha, K.C. Ramamurthy, Arun Singh, Vikas Mahatme, Ashok Bajpayee, Dr. D.P. Watts, Jayaprakash Nishad, Vinesa Hastrabuddhe and T.G. Venkatesh had 100% attendance in standing committee meetings.
I am happy to learn that I am one among the 16 Rajya Sabha members who have attended all the respective standing committee meetings, parliamentary standing committee meetings, and the secretariat has published our name. I am also happy to learn that appreciations were given by our Honorable Chairman and our Vice President about the regular attendance. Honorable Chairman has emphasized that every member should endeavor to attend their respective parliamentary standing committee meetings without any default, and ultimately the party which has sent these members to the house have to monitor about their regular attendance.
Comparison of party-wise attendance record shows that the average attendance of 92 BJP members of Rajya Sabha in these meetings last year has been 56.56%.
I'm happy that the Rajya Sabha chairman has appreciated the work of Parliamentary Standing Committee on Education, Women, Children, Youth and Sports. And as chairman of the committee, I wholeheartedly thank the chairman of the Rajya Sabha, Honorable Vice President. The fact is that parliamentary standing committees are one of the important features of our parliamentary system, and therefore when members ensure that their attendance is 100%, naturally it impacts on the quality of deliberations. I would certainly say that most of our members try to attend 100% meetings of the parliamentary standing committee. I'm sure in the days to come also all the members will make it a point to attend every other meeting of the parliamentary standing committee.
I am very happy that I've been able to attend all the committee meetings and mark the 100% attendance. I had the privilege of being a member of a number of committees, and I have enjoyed each and every committee and its deliberations. I was in the urban development, I was in the law and justice standing committee, I was in the standing committee of industry, and now I am in the standing committee of education, youth, child, women and sports. I also have the privilege of being the chairman of the Rajya Sabha committee. Attendance to the committees is very, very crucial and very, very important. It's not that it's just attending any other meeting. A committee, a standing committee in particular, will be reviewing the functioning of the department or the ministry very thoroughly. It is the bridge between the parliament, the executive and the people. You know, the committees even call the people's representatives, the various organizations, and take their evidence on various issues.
I personally feel ke ek to membran ne committee ki meetings को बहुत रेगुलरली अटेंड करना चाहिए. उनको देश हित में और डेमोक्रेसी के हित में सीरियसली लेके काम में कंट्रीब्यूट करें, उसमें अपना योगदान दें, क्योंकि हर एक प्रेजेंटेशन पार्लियामेंट में पॉसिबल नहीं है. और कुछ ऐसे पार्लियामेंट में होने वाले बिल्स हैं जो कमेटीज़ को रेफ़र किए जाते हैं, और उन बिलों पर फिर कमेटी उसको कंसीडर करके, स्क्रूटनाइज करके अपनी रिकमेंडेशंस देती है. ये बिल्स स्पीकर लोकसभा और माननीय चेयरमैन राज्यसभा में से कोई भी पार्लियामेंट्री स्टैंडिंग कमेटी को रेफ़र कर सकते हैं.
In the last 3 years, Chairman N. Venkaiah Naidu has been regularly reviewing the functioning of the 8 committees serviced by the Rajya Sabha in respect of attendance and duration of the meetings. He has often urged the chairman of the committees to ensure attendance of 50% in every meeting and maintain a duration of 2.5 hours per meeting. As a result, there has been a steady improvement in these aspects.
In respect of demands for grants 2020-21, the 8 committees of Rajya Sabha have held 20 meetings and discussed the demands of 18 ministries over a total duration of 63 hours. Taking into consideration that the parliament meets for about 6 hours during each sitting, the total time spent by these 8 committees examining the demands of various ministries in effect amounts to over 10 sittings of parliament. Proportionately, the work done by the 16 committees of Lok Sabha amounts to another 20 sittings of the parliament. In all, the work put in by the total 24 DRSCs in examining the demands for grants of all the ministries equal to 30 days of functioning of the parliament, which is quite significant. That alone takes the total of sittings of parliament during a year to over 100 days.
To streamline the functioning of parliamentary committees through better participation, the Office of Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla has asked for a detailed report on the attendance of members in these committees in the last financial year. Apart from that, a committee has also been formed to look into the rules that govern the functioning of the panels and suggest changes that are necessary in light of the developments in recent years.
So how are the members nominated to the respective committees? Well, the parties mutually agree and leaders are then asked to submit names of the members for the consideration by the presiding officers by a specific date.
In suggesting names, leaders generally keep in mind that as far as possible, a member doesn't serve on a committee for more than 2 terms in a row. So far as seats available to smaller groups, independents and unattached members are concerned, the presiding officers nominate members to the committees from among them. After receiving all the names, presiding officers approve nomination of members to various committees. The nominated members are notified in the Parliamentary Bulletin Part 2. They're also formally informed individually.
Like almost all things in Parliament, the membership of parliamentary committees is dependent upon the strength of political parties in Parliament. The departmentally related standing committees are split between the two secretariats of Parliament. There are some committees which are looked at by the Lok Sabha Secretariat, and there are some committees which are looked at by the Rajya Sabha Secretariat. Lok Sabha is a bigger house, so in parliamentary committees, there are more number of members from Lok Sabha. Rajya Sabha has comparatively lesser number of members. Now, the membership between the two houses is fixed. So Lok Sabha has 2/3 members in a parliamentary committee and Rajya Sabha has 1/3 members. And this membership is then further divided between political parties based on their strength in the two houses.
As in the case with several other practices of Indian parliamentary democracy, the institution of parliamentary committees also has its origins in the British Parliament. The first parliamentary committee was constituted in 1517 in Britain. The Public Accounts Committee was established in 1861. In India, the first Public Accounts Committee was constituted in April 1950.
Well, that's all we had for you in this edition of Sansad TV. Thanks for watching and stay tuned.